Alcaraz is number one in the world again and just won Indian Wells without dropping a set, and he could be on his way to winning a Sunshine Double. It's safe to say that he's unstoppable. But before we get into the video, 96% of you guys watching my videos aren't subscribed. So if you guys enjoy tennis content like this, make sure to subscribe and check out my other tennis videos. Alright, so before this season, Alcaraz was dealing with some injuries and he did have to drop out of the Australian Open, and I kind of thought that he would struggle coming back. But he really didn't. I mean, he won the Argentina Open and made the final of the Rio Open, but due to an injury, his level kind of dropped towards the end, and Kaminar is able to take the title, but he still made the final, which is really impressive. And I wasn't sure what to expect in Indian Wells. I mean, obviously Novak wasn't playing, Rafa wasn't playing, so definitely the field was more wide open, but Medvedev was on a huge streak. But somehow Alcaraz kind of just overcame all that and didn't drop a set, also beating Sinner in the semifinal, which was honestly a pretty good match to watch. But Alcaraz just overpowered everyone, and he made Medvedev look really silly in that final. Other thing that I was thinking was that, like, was he gonna be able to, like, keep up this level throughout all of Miami also? I wasn't really sure, and I was like, we can just wait and see. And so far, it's looking really good. I mean, he does have a tough semifinal against Sinner, and Sinner could definitely come back for revenge. I mean, Sinner's beaten him before, so it's gonna be a tough match. And obviously Medvedev's on the other side of the draw, so even if he does get to the final, he might have to go through Medvedev or Khachanov. Anyways, as I'm recording this video right now, I just finished watching the Alcaraz versus Fritz match, and he dominated the entire time. I don't really think Fritz had much of a chance. All right, so Alcaraz has been on the record saying that he does want to win the Sunshine Double, as there's very few players that have done it. And between the ATP and the WTA, there's been 12 people. I'll put them up here. But it's actually kind of crazy that Novak has won it so many times. That just shows the level of greatness he has. But anyway, so yeah, if Alcaraz does somehow do this, he'll be the youngest player ever to win the Sunshine Double. And I think he might be the only person that's done it without ever dropping a set, assuming he does win everything in straight sets. That'll be unlikely, but you never know what could happen right now. All right, so obviously if Alcaraz does win Miami, he'll be back at the number one, because due to the live rankings, he's technically the number two player because he dropped all his points, but yeah. And obviously Novak hasn't been able to play either of these two tournaments, so he's just been practicing on clay. I mean, I've seen lots of videos of those, but this brings us all into clay season, because clay season is coming up really, really soon. And honestly, clay is my favorite, if you guys don't know. But anyways, Novak and Alcaraz will have a huge rivalry throughout the entire clay season, and this will be fun to watch. I mean, Alcaraz did beat Novak last year. I think, was it Madrid? Or Rome, I'm not sure exactly, but yeah. Alcaraz is a very strong clay player, and he's definitely gonna be one of the top contenders for Roland Garros. So I'm assuming he's gonna bring all this momentum into the clay season. And right now, to me, he's looking like one of the best players, and I'm not sure if anyone can stop him, even Novak. Really curious to see how the rest of the season will pan out, because obviously Novak is really, really good on grass, and Alcaraz wasn't that good. I mean, it took a player like Sinner to beat him, so like obviously he's still a pretty good grass player. But I'm curious to see if he can pick up a lot of points and somehow get the number one ranking. I mean, he has a lot to defend, including the US Open. So like, this would be honestly the most impossible thing if he gets number one at the end of the year. And honestly, it could be one of the best like seasons we've seen recently. All right, so Alcaraz is looking really unstoppable to me, but I want you guys to comment what you guys think. You guys think Novak will be able to beat him, especially during the clay season? But yeah, comment what you think.